Hello, you beautiful souls, welcome here. Thank you very much for coming to my channel, for all of your kindness, all of your love, your support, your wonderful comments and your generous donations. I'm very, very grateful to all of you. Thank you. Merry Christmas to all of you who celebrate it. In my culture, we don't celebrate Christmas, but I've always lived for some reason in countries that celebrate it on a big scale. So I really enjoyed watching this whole magical atmosphere unfolding and people getting distracted from difficult things in life for a second, which is always nice. So yeah, today we've got a love reading and it's about your person's feelings towards you. I've got three piles of cards for you to choose from. I will insert the picture of the piles in a second. As always, take your time, listen to intuition. You can say the name of your person out loud or in your mind to connect to them better. And then choose a pile that attracts you the most. Let's go. Hello, my beautiful pile number one, or everyone who chose white obsidian stone. Let's see, how does your person feel about you? And I apologize for obnoxious music that is playing outside. I can't do anything about it. There is like a Christmas fair going on and I would be happy if it was Christmas music, but it's some kind of club pop situation that's not too pleasant for people's ears. Anyway, don't want to get distracted. How does your person feel about you, pile one? We are opening your reading with the Three of Wands, Priest, King of Wands, Hope, Five of Swords, and Wife. Playful, very playful this person is, with you especially. I feel like I'm sensing that they're very interested in you. First of all, they have a lot of passion for you, very interested, very curious about you, this person is. And in the past, we've got this energy of Three of Wands and Priest. You feel like something very desirable, interesting, and difficult to reach for them for some reason. With this Three of Wands, there is this energy of planning, of strategizing, of trying to find solutions, of cutting the distance, if that's the case. Maybe there is distance between some of you here. Finding ways to approach you, finding ways to get closer to you. This person was all about, what do I do? What do I do? There is this angsty feeling like, this is so interesting. This is the person that is there on my mind 24/7. I can't stop thinking about them with this priest. It's almost like there is something pure in you, something very, maybe some higher knowledge or just wisdom that this person is craving. Plus, on top of that, they're very passionate about you. And all of this coming, the result of all of it is them planning, making up the strategies, trying to figure out how they can approach you, how can they get close to you. Definitely very interested in you, this person. Definitely planning in regards to this connection, definitely yearning for you. And I don't feel like it's someone who likes to sit around and wait, to be honest. This feels like a person of action to me. Could be a fire sign, could be an air sign, someone quite energetic, someone very charismatic, someone who likes to pursue, I feel like. But you somehow, you hooked them, you've got something interesting about you. I don't know what it is, it will be different for all of you guys, but there's just something that you know that this person is craving, or something that you live and preach. Preach and live, something that you believe in possibly, maybe your lifestyle, something about you is just so enticing, interesting for them, curious for them. It's like you are this rainbow ahead in the horizon that they are just in awe of. I want to get there. This looks amazing. I want to get there. That's the energy of your person in the past. That's how they were feeling. Very intrigued. Very excited. wanting to come up with a plan in regards to you. How do they feel at the moment? Oh, it's almost like this person is trying to be strong, trying to stay in their power and not lose their hope with you, because it's, I feel like maybe there are some hiccups in this connection, some difficulties, but they're still very focused on you. They like the way you make them feel. They like who they are by your side. It's almost like their feeling, the way they feel about themselves, is so much better when you are around. Like they see themselves as someone, a better person, someone more wise, someone more strong, someone more brave, courageous, someone even maybe more successful. I definitely feel like this person would like to impress you in some way. They're very focused on you, very determined with this King of Wands. And I do feel like there is a lot of passion here, very passionate about you guys. Very physically attracted, very drawn to your energy. And there is this almost like blind hope that they've got in their heart about you. I don't want to give up on this. This person makes me feel good. I want to be closer to them. It might be that you are not quite aware of all of this, because we've got the Five of Swords coming in. But it's interesting how this person is just not giving up, I would say. I don't feel like they're giving up, if that was your question, or you were wondering if they gave up. No, not really. And I feel like they've been working on self-esteem very recently to make sure that they are someone admirable, someone respectable. It's all about how they feel within themselves. I feel like that's what you are triggering in them almost. How they feel about themselves, whether they're strong enough, brave enough, courageous enough, ambitious enough. That's at least how they want you to see them. Yeah, and very hopeful energy currently in regards to you, very hopeful. Even though the situation might be quite difficult, not very promising, I do feel like they're holding on the last hope, on the last reasons, or maybe hints, signs that this connection may work out. Future energies. I feel like this is quite a secretive person, to be honest, pile one, and they're not sharing as much as you would like them to, about their plans, about their ideas in regards to you, how they see you, what you mean to them. And there is this big secret that they have in regards to you, and this is such an interesting combination. I've never seen it before, Five of Swords and Wife. So they're hiding something. What is it they're hiding? They're hiding that you mean a great deal to them, that they would want to potentially down the line, down the road, end up with you, marry you, build a family with you. Yeah, maybe propose, something like that. But it feels like a big secret at the moment, something they don't want you to know, with this Five of Swords and Wife. Hiding it, not talking about it. Or if you are communicating about the future, it's almost like they're being evasive about it. They are quite slippery. Maybe they change the topic, or maybe they are elusive, they're not straight to the point. For some reason, they're not talking about it as much. Maybe that's the surprise they want to, they want to surprise you with some proposal or something serious, like, do you want to move in? Do you want to get married? Something like that. Interesting person you are dealing with. Again, strong fire and air combination energy I'm feeling here. I don't really feel much water from this person, definitely a lot of fire and just a little bit of air energy. And I do feel like they're serious about you. I don't feel like this person is a player, or they want to just have fun and then leave the situation. I feel like they're quite serious, because with this priest, they immediately felt like you are the real deal. You are someone who can completely change their life, turn their perception of the world, of change their beliefs, like 180. They believe you. Somehow everything you say, they believe you, and there is this blind faith and hope in you, in what you show them, just following you. But I feel like this person themselves, they needed to work on their ego, on their self-esteem, on their confidence with this King of Wands, Three of Wands, come up with some sort of plan, be a little bit more proactive. That's what they had to do here. But they're quite serious about you. That's what I'm feeling. Let's look at the bottom of the deck. We've got the Queen of Wands. Power couple here. The King of Wands, the Queen of Wands. Yes, they feel like you are their match. You are their lobster. Friends. If you watched Friends, you know what I'm talking about. They definitely see you as someone who is their equal, who would be an amazing partner in life, in crime, in love for them. Definitely admire you very much. It might have been that they had to reach your level of success, of confidence, just to level up somehow, to be on the same... I feel like you have been much more confident in the past. You know your worth. You're much more powerful. You're much more maybe influential. Maybe you're more successful in your career. And then with the Three of Wands and then going to the King of Wands, they only hope they can reach your level. They only hope that you can pay some attention to them, that you see that they are your equal as well. Very interesting. But here, they feel like you are... what's the expression? Of one kind. You're very similar. You're made of the same stuff. I hope I'm making sense right now. But let's look at your oracle cards and see. Oh yes, oh my gosh. Somehow I feel like this person has been secluded recently, or you have not been physically together. Somehow they're away from you. Maybe you broke up. Maybe you have a difficult period in your connection, and this person is overthinking a lot. They have many thoughts about you. How I was saying in the beginning that they keep thinking about you 24/7. We've got this card, Thinker, trying to answer their deep questions. Why am I so drawn to them, to this pile one person? Why am I still hoping to make this work? How can I resolve the situation? How can I find the solution? And I feel like they're very, very jealous, this person, especially if you try to move on, or maybe they see you with other people, or maybe they see how other people admire you. There's a lot of jealousy here with this card, Envy. Again, I feel like self-esteem issues is something this person was battling in the past, since meeting you. Am I good enough for them? Will I be able to reach the same level as they are at the moment? Will they choose me? I don't feel like they... it's almost like there is this negative self-talk in them. And then we've got this card, the Fledging. Again, it's almost like this person is a little bit... They might have been inexperienced when you met. Maybe you had more experiences in relationship, or maybe you're just wiser, and they feel like someone who has a path to walk before you come together. They have to maybe improve their career, become more confident, maybe, I don't know, even move out of their parents, something like that with the Fledging, like the bird that is leaving the nest and takes the first flight. I feel like you help them grow. You help them grow into themselves again with this King of Wands, because we started with the Three of Wands and then we are going to the King of Wands. Become more themselves. To believe in themselves again. They have definitely grown with you. And then we've got this card, Solitude. Again, I feel like this person is quite lonely for some reason. Maybe you left them to their thoughts, to their, I don't know, ideas, and set some ultimatums, or maybe put some strong boundaries. But there is this feeling like they're searching for answers, trying to come up with a plan, with some sort of solution. And I don't feel like they're saying as much as... Well, how do I explain it? They know more and they think more than they're letting on about you, about this connection, especially with this Five of Swords. They have big plans, but you're not aware of them. That's the energy I'm getting here. And then we've got this card, Inner Sanctuary or Zen Garden, very similar to the Solitude card and the hermit card in traditional tarot. I do feel like it's beneficial for this person to take their time if they took a step back and they're not, maybe they're a little bit distant with you at the moment. I feel like it's very much needed for them, so they clear their headspace, come up with a plan or with a strategy and implement what it is that they want with you, act finally. Raise their self-esteem, feel a little bit better about themselves. They really needed it. And there's this feeling of trying to find positivity, trying to find hope, because it's almost like this person sometimes can get too stuck in their head, in their logic, in their jealousy, feeling left out possibly. Yeah, and very lonely. Let's get some messages from them. Pile one. What does your person want you to know right now? Messages from your person. We've got this card. And I apologize for the look of my cards because I got perfume all over them when I was traveling, but they still work. I checked it. And it says, I hope that you can forgive me one day. Yeah, maybe this person took their time. Maybe they couldn't finally act and pursue you or make some sort of decision here. With this Three of Wands, it's almost like maybe there was distance between you two, or maybe there was some circumstances separating you and they couldn't overcome those. They couldn't fix the situation somehow. But I don't feel like they're a bad person necessarily. I don't think so. You mean a lot to them. They're very hopeful about the future with you. They like the way you make them feel. You came closer than anyone. Yeah, exactly. And you have influenced them in a really massive way with this priest, hope, wife. It's almost like you showed them the way somehow. Maybe you helped them to change their routines, to influence their beliefs or their spirituality, or maybe just showed them their path, their purpose in life. Your morals and principles somehow changed them. And then another apology. I know I messed up everything. A lot of regret is coming through from them. Let's get some more messages. How does your person feel about you, pile one? What are your person's feelings towards you right now? And, oh my gosh, yes, I was saying that they miss you. They feel so lonely. And this message here, I miss you more than you know. Mm-hmm. For some reason, they're so lonely. Even if they have many people around them, it's not the same. It's not you. I will do anything to bring you happiness. Yeah. And I feel like they're hiding it. For some reason, I feel like they're quite shy about it. How much your happiness means to them, how much you mean to them with this Five of Swords and wife, and how much hope they've got still in their heart in regards to all of this. And then we've got a lot of passion here. My whole body burns at the thought of you. With all of this Wands energy, Three of Wands, King of Wands, you really activate this person. What else do they want you to know right now, pile one? Messages from your person. Pile number one. What does your person want you to know right now? Even though we are apart, I'm slowly falling in love with you. I feel like they already love you. And the distance doesn't change anything. The circumstances don't change anything. The fact that you're not together probably right now physically doesn't make them love you less. I have a lot of things on my mind. Yeah, that overthinking energy and negative self-talk we were talking about previously. I'm in love with your body. No doubt. No doubt. Should we get more messages? How does your person feel about you from this deck? Pile one, how does your person feel about you right now? We've got this card, retreat. It says it's time to disconnect from the world. And all of this isolation energy we were getting with the solitude, fledging, in a sanctuary. It could be that this person is going within. I'm like 90% sure that they are not as expressive as they are usually with you. Or maybe some of you are not in communication at all. And if you were wondering if they got into a new connection or they're interested in someone else, I don't think so. I don't feel like they're ready. It's more so like the time of healing and resting, trying to find balance. Should we get more cards from this deck? Oh my gosh. Pile one, how does your person feel about you right now? We've got two cards that wanted to flip out. The first one is the union of hearts, a love connection that defies explanation. That's so beautiful. Again, that feeling that they feel you through distance, through time, through whatever happened, the conditions, circumstances. Maybe there's something that makes it impossible for you to be together at the moment, but love is still there. The connection, you still feel it, the both of you. And then we've got this card, romance. Lavish the one you love with personal attention and affection. They still feel very romantic about you, very passionate about you. And I feel like they would like to share that with you quite soon. To be honest here, with this Five of Swords and wife, even though they have some secrets that they're keeping some things away, hidden from you, I feel like soon they will reach out and express them. So this is all I have for you, Pile 1. I hope this reading has answered some of your questions, has resonated with you, and I wish you lots of happiness and lots of love for yourself and for others, and I will see you in my next video. Bye-bye. Hello, my beautiful Pile number 2, or everyone who chose the turquoise tone. I'm not sure if I pronounced it right, but I think I did. Let's see, how does your person feel about you right now? We are opening the reading with the Four of Wands. Sweetheart. Five of Swords. Love. Page of Swords. And Melancholy. Pile 2, you gave them so much happiness. With this energy, Four of Wands and Sweetheart in the past, I feel like you made them feel so warm, so happy, so joyful, and there is this feeling, I found my person, this is my home, this is just someone who makes me so happy, so cheerful, and there's this feeling of warmth, of stability, of being grounded, of, yes, home. Like family energy. I sense a lot of admiration for you. This feeling of familiarity, comfort. And the Four of Wands is almost like it's I want this to last. That's the feeling I'm getting from them. They wanted things to last with you. There is a lot of kindness here, a lot of tenderness. And they took this connection very seriously. If you were confused about their intentions or how they felt about you initially, definitely very serious this person was about you. I want to... it's almost like this. They saw this as something very promising. Long-term commitment, definitely that's what they wanted with you. And they absolutely love the way you look. Maybe the way you dress for some of you, there is this... they're finding you absolutely gorgeous. Your appearance, the way you express yourself. It's like it's very close to my heart. This is what I like. Maybe you remind them of someone. Maybe it's just you are their type completely, 100%. And there is this click. I like it. This feels good. But what's going on currently with you and them? There is love here. I can't deny it. There is love here. And it's very pure and it's very almost childlike and innocent, and they definitely have been hit by Cupid. But there is this feeling of being defeated. There is this conflict. It could be the conflict between the two of you or the conflict within them. Almost as though you can't work some things out and you're always finding yourself on a battleground when you are together, when you're discussing something. It's almost like there is this turbulence that I'm feeling about you and them. Almost like love is not enough in this connection. That's how this person feels. With this five of swords and this little Cupid. Yeah, disappointment. And I don't feel like disappointment in you, but in maybe something that they can't provide you. The fact that this connection is not working out, the fact that maybe you are going against each other and arguing and disagreeing on something. But underneath all of that, we've got this beautiful love. It's just mental blocks and conflicts and communication struggles. And maybe one person is expecting one thing of another and the other person can't deliver it, or they just function differently. They cannot maybe read your mind. Maybe it's very mutual. It's just maybe it's love languages don't match within this connection. And there's hence this feeling of defeatedness, of being tired, exhausted, and almost like ego battles, ego struggles and competition. I just want to be right now, and that's why I'm arguing with my loved one. And then when you win this argument, it just feels like, what was all of it for? Now that we are looking in separate ways, sitting in different parts of the room, and the connection is kind of torn apart. That's the frustration and disappointment I'm feeling in them. Not in you or who you are as a person, but in the way they can't, it's difficult to have this connection run smoothly. As though there are some rocks on your path that you keep stumbling on. Yeah, and it literally feels like this person is sitting there and, what have I done? Or what do we do now? How do we fix this? That's the image I'm getting from them. Future energies. We've got the Page of Swords and Melancholy. Again, sadness. For some reason, maybe there was a major argument in the past. I really apologize for obnoxious music coming from outside, but I can't help it. There is like a Christmas fair happening and all kinds of music mashed, mixed together, and it sounds not too pleasant. And especially not for the tarot reading, but I'll try to focus, and I hope it's not distracting for you too. So the future energies, I feel like this person is planning to keeping an eye on you, spying on you for sure, maybe checking your social media if you're not talking, if the communication is not going too well, if you feel like you're struggling. It's almost like going against the what's the phrase, like it's a struggle, it's not effortless, the communication or this connection at the moment. Some of you feel frustrated, one of you feels frustrated, another one feels hurt and angry, and there's this mixture of difficult emotions, inner conflict, difficult thoughts. But the future energies, I feel like this person is missing you very much, and they definitely are going to be checking your social media, spying on you, keeping an eye on you, because they can't stop thinking about the situation. They're worried that this is, is this the end? Is this the dynamic that's going to continue? Can we make it work still? Yeah, definitely. I'm sensing loneliness from them. of not having you by their side, of not feeling your energy anymore, your warmth. There is this feeling of lack. They're constantly curious and almost like worried mentally, what's going on with you? Where are you? Who are you with? What's happening in your life with this Page of Swords? Like this hectic overthinking and restlessness in their mind, I'm sensing. Let's look at the bottom of your deck. Well, too. What is the background story here? A lot of anxiety. It almost feels as though in the beginning everything was so good, so perfect. It was aligning perfectly. This connection felt so comfortable, so easygoing. It felt like home. It felt as though you're meant to be together. They've never felt so comfortable with anybody else before. But then the problems started coming one by one, and now they've accumulated to the point where there is this feeling of slight resentment and disappointment at the fact that things are getting harder and harder in this connection. And this person is very anxious about you, about your connection. They're definitely not indifferent. Maybe they're even struggling to sleep. I feel like there is a lot of overthinking, a lot of negative self-talk, a lot of worry about the future, maybe even guilt or shame. Difficult state they are in with this Nine of Swords. And a lot of Swords energy we've got there. Nine of Swords, Five of Swords, Page of Swords. They're very much in their mind, picking their brain, trying to find a solution, trying to find peace and closure and understanding of what can be done here. Let's look at your Oracle card spell too. How does your person feel about you right now? Yeah, you see, deep within them, they know that you are the one. They know that you're meant to be together. They're very attuned to you with this deep knowing. It's almost like you have this beautiful connection that is felt even through distance, through time, a spiritual connection. Intuitively, they are very attuned to you. It's almost like sometimes you can talk without words, but when you start talking with words, that's where problems appear. That's where you're clashing against each other. That's where ego comes into the picture. Then we've got this card, Fifth Chakra or Archangel Gabriel. Again, communication. I feel like this person understands how important it is to be honest with you, how important it is to communicate better, probably. Because with this Five of Swords, this Page of Swords, maybe that was the breaking, like the Achilles heel in this connection, communication. Either yours or theirs, that's not appropriate, not almost like mature, maybe. Yeah, I feel like they have a lot to say to you, but they're holding back for some reason, this person. They're not saying everything they would like to say. Then we've got this card, Patience and Planning. I definitely feel like this person is not letting you go. They're still very focused on you, even though there is a little bit of sadness and feeling like they're lacking you in their life. But they're still planning. They still feel like you've got this beautiful foundation that you've already put into the ground. You've got this basis for your connection, even if it's a friendship between you two. It's still a very powerful connection that bonds you two, and they're not giving up. They feel like they already planted the seeds into the soil. At some point, your beautiful tree is bound to give fruits, and they're waiting. And then we've got this card, Strength, which depicts a beautiful, strong, big tree trunk. Yeah, I do feel like for this person, this situation, the bond between you two is incredibly strong, and they've never experienced anything like this. And love is there, so they don't want to give up. They definitely don't want to give up. They feel like this connection can stand the test of time. It can be durable, even though currently there are some hiccups and rocky path, road underneath your feet. I feel like this person thinks that you're both strong enough to last through all of it and not fall apart. And also a very family oriented energy I'm feeling, with the strength and with this tree, and we've got the Four of Wands, which is also like an epitome, the card that's infused with the family energy, with the energy of marriage, of commitment, of stability, stable relationship. So yeah. And then we have this beautiful card Ganesha, and it says clearing away obstacles, protection, guidance. Yeah, exactly. This person just wants all these difficulties to fall away. They want to solve this difficult period you are in, this crisis you both are in, and to come out on the other side more hopeful. And it's almost like they want protection for this connection. They want it to be more, how do I explain it? Yeah, divinely protected. They want help, they want guidance, they want support. Because somehow they know you belong together, somehow they know that they can be happy with you. They've invested so much into this already, so much time, so much energy, maybe so much finances or whatever it is. Yeah, even though there is sadness, there is sorrow and disappointment, I don't feel like they're ready to give up. They had and still have very big hopes and dreams in regards to you. Let's get some messages from your person, pile two. What do they want you to know right now? What does your person want you to know right now? We've got this card. I couldn't let you get close to me. I feel like it's one of their big regrets here, with this Five of Swords and love. They feel a lot of love for you, and they know that you love them too, but maybe there are some circumstances, or maybe their own fears or memories from their past situations. It's almost like it could have been that they sabotaged this connection. That's what I'm feeling as well here, and they regret it for sure if that's the case. Then we've got this card, I want to be more than friends. Yeah, especially if some of you have said, listen, I can't continue this connection, I love you, but let's just be friends, let's keep it more simple, it's getting too complicated, I don't feel like we should be together or something like that. I don't feel like this person is happy with that offer or situation or dynamic between the two of you. Because again, with this love and Five of Swords in the middle of your spread, they love you. They want more, for sure. And sweetheart, they definitely want more than friendship here. I bury myself in work to forget you. Because sometimes their thoughts with that Nine of Swords we just pulled, we have at the bottom of your deck, sometimes their thoughts are just too much, are just too heavy and too difficult to deal with. Almost depressive feelings I'm getting from them. What else do they want you to know, pile two? Messages from your person. What do they want you to know right now? Don't think I don't care about you, because I really do. Oh, they do. Absolutely. Don't even doubt it. My whole body burns at the thought of you. There's also a lot of passion there still. Very passionate about you, this person. I'm entwined in the thought of finding you one day. With this melancholy, and I feel like they miss you a lot. And they can't stop thinking about reconciliation or getting closer to each other or fixing your bond somehow. What else? What else do they want you to know, pile two? Messages from your person. I don't know, I feel like I'm feeling the energy of like, oh, the sight of disappointment and sadness for things not going the way they planned. Like, look at that. We've got this message. I'm aware that I'm ghosting you. I wish I could treat you better, but I'm not fully ready. It could be the fact that the conflict that you had, the disagreement or argument that you had, and I feel like this person is so angry at the situation, at themselves. I don't think they're very angry at you, to be honest. It's just they don't feel like they have anything good to bring to you, to share with you, to... If you were to communicate, it's almost like they would hurt you, and they don't want to do it. Maybe that's why they're pushing back a little bit. But they're still keeping an eye on you, absolutely. Now look at this message. One day I will go down on my knee and offer you a lifetime of love. Yeah, with this Four of Wands energy, this strength, they've got big plans in regards to you. It's just now they're not in a good mind space. Their heart is in a good place still for you. They love you very much. But their mind space, very chaotic. And they want to propose to you, marry you eventually. So don't give up just yet if that's where you are energetically at the moment. Being angry, tired, wanting to give up. If this connection means to you something still, I feel like it's worth waiting for them. The advice I was just giving you, they support it. The final message: I am so afraid you will leave me in the end. I feel like this is why all of it is happening. Their fears, anxieties, and sabotaging this whole situation. Maybe they're trying to seem all breezy and lighthearted, and that this connection doesn't really mean anything to them, when for them it has already put strong roots into their heart, like this big tree. It's a very important bond for them, and eventually even they see you two building a family together, ending up together in a commitment. It's just they're scared that you will leave them first. I feel like you will be the one who gets away. Let's get more messages. Which deck? This one. How does your person feel about you? Pile 2. What are your person's feelings towards you right now? We've got this card, deception. Someone is wearing a false self-mask in this relationship. Yeah, I feel like what they're saying to you is definitely not what they're feeling. With this Five of Swords, Page of Swords. They're very sad, and they have a lot of love for you. But I feel like their communication is a little bit more hectic, a little bit more, like, spiky, sharp, and defensive, I would say. Like trying to win a battle when there is no battle, in reality. That's the energy I'm getting from them. There is nothing to argue about here. Let's just make it work. But they want to argue. At the bottom of the deck, we've got this card, True Love. This is a romance of a lifetime. It is a true love for them. Ego. That's what it is, ego. What else? How does your person feel about you, Pile 2? What are your person's feelings towards you? We've got this card, Choose Love. You always have choice. Make yours with love. And I feel like this person is standing at crossroads at the moment. Do I choose my ego, my anxiety and my fears, or do I choose the love that I have for this person? Do we have at the bottom of the deck? Oh my gosh, another True Love card. You guys, you can't make it up. On both decks we've got the same message, True Love. I'm not kidding. What does it say? The love is once in a life. This love is once in a lifetime, it says. Such a beautiful imagery on it, on this card. Wow. So this is all I have for you, Pile 2. I hope this reading has given you the answers you were looking for, has resonated with you, and I wish you lots of happiness and lots of love for yourself and for others. And I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye. Hello, my beautiful Pile number 3, or everyone who chose the Citrine Stone. Let's see, how does your person feel about you? And we are opening your reading with the Five of Swords, Despair, Nine of Cups, Waiting, Ten of Cups, and Joyfulness. Oh my gosh. It's been so heavy. It's been so heavy, this connection for this person and for you. So dark, so full of conflict and ego battle and despair, sadness and this frustration. Resentment, that's what I'm feeling here. But I'm talking about the past energy with this Five of Swords and despair. Very recently there have been some clashes between you and your person. Maybe some misunderstandings, maybe things are... It's almost like you were working against each other rather than with each other. Not... there is not enough... It's like... How do I explain it well? It's like each one of... Each and every... Oh my gosh, I can't speak. Both of you wanted to be right. That's the best way to explain it. Both of you wanted to be right in the situation, in whatever was going on. And by that you were hurting each other and yourself. And that's why this situation was so desperate. So it felt like it was not going to come to any resolution or closure here. The energy I'm getting here, it's almost like we can't be together, but we can't be apart either. That's what I'm feeling here. And that's how your person felt as well. When will this conflict end? When will this anger end? When will we stop going at each other? With this Five of Swords, it's like a battleground here in this connection. Even if these were not a very overt arguments, fights, it's just the energy in your connection is like very intense and very inflamed, I would even say. And tiring and exhausting. I apologize for obnoxious music outside of my window, and there is a huge fair, Christmas fair going on, and I cannot help it. And maybe an hour ago at least it was like jingle bells and some Christmas nice old style music. Now it's pop and some strange beats. I hope it's not distracting for you. So yeah, in the past I'm feeling a lot of sadness, a lot of regret, and a lot of confrontations and conflicts. Yeah, conflicts, the best way to explain it. Not being able to work things out together. Hiding things from each other, maybe. Maybe passive-aggressive energy is present here, like a battleground again. What's going on now with this person? Oh my gosh, you are their wish fulfillment. I feel like... regardless of what happened in the past, they're still waiting for a resolution here. They're still waiting for things to become brighter, more happier. With this Nine of Cups, it's just if things worked out, if you were together, if you finally reconciled or were physically together, if you met up, it would be the biggest wish come true. They would be the happiest person on earth. Yeah. Emotionally, you cover so many of their needs, you make them so satisfied, so fulfilled, and their heart is singing when they're around you. Yeah. It's almost like they're waiting for something to happen. I feel like for many of you it will be a different thing. For some of you it would be traveling to each other, or for others it would be for you to forgive them, or for you to finally get in a communication, to express your feelings to each other. They're waiting for this kind of emotional catharsis in this connection, because they know how much pain you can cause them, but at the same time they know how happy you can make them, and that's something that keeps them hopeful at the moment. That's something that they're choosing to focus on. Yeah, it's like their biggest wish. I do feel like this person is manifesting you. They're dreaming about you, they're setting their intentions, they are maybe looking at your picture, imagining you together. And it's like a huge manifestation, intention setting process that's going on, consciously or unconsciously, that they're just waiting for it to finally come to the 3D, to reality, to be with you finally. Very nice energy. It's like you are their biggest wish, They've got everything else. You would be the final touch that just illuminates the whole picture and fills their heart with happiness and contentment. Future energies, we've got the Ten of Cups and joyfulness. It's like a continuation of happiness, family energy, maybe engagement, maybe proposal. This Ten of Cups, it's such a beautiful card in this deck. Two people making this incredible figure, or I don't know, pose, position, and holding each other, supporting each other, almost like on a pedestal. So beautiful. And it's almost like it was worth it. You stepping, leveling up every step of the way, every single step, and getting to the top and making this beautiful monument of yourselves, and finally building a beautiful connection, maybe even a family. Ten of Cups is a very family-oriented energy, and it would bring them so much joy to be with you, to experience this love, to be physically together for some of you if you've been separated, to build a family, to build a future together. Biggest wish. This person is very serious about you. Even if the things were difficult in the past, now they're definitely manifesting you and they want a future with you. They know they will be happy with you. That's the energy I'm getting here. It's only a matter of time. They just have to wait a little bit. That's the feeling I'm getting here. Let's look at the bottom of your deck. Pile 3. What do we have here? We've got the King of Pentacles. Oh wow. They find you as... I feel like they admire you very much. And in the past, I feel like you were a little bit more... There is a lot of stability in you, a lot of grounded energy, a lot of... you value yourself, you know your worth, there is a really good self-esteem here, and maybe you were not settling for less with this person, or maybe you were putting strong boundaries or stating what it is you want this connection to be. And it's almost like that's where the conflicts were born in the past. But they definitely see you as the one, see you as the person they want to build their future with. As this beautiful, warm, nourishing, kind presence in their life. You ground them somehow. Pile 3. And again, very strong energy of family with this Queen of Pentacles. Let's look at your Oracle cards now. Yeah. I feel like there is a lot of sadness here if you are not in a communication with this person or if things are not going too well, because we've got this card Lost Love here, and it says surrender, healing and release. I feel like what this person was doing in the past as well, trying to come to peace and acceptance that these conflicts, these misunderstandings, they were chipping away the trust you had with each other. But I feel like this person would like to risk, still they would like this connection to be successful. They still have big plans for it, big hopes for it. Because they love you. Yeah, they do. We've got this kind of memories of love. They're very nostalgic about you. They keep remembering those warm, heartwarming moments between the two of you. When you felt so much happiness, so much joy together. I definitely feel like you have a past, you have a journey with this person. But there is a sense of wanting to start anew, try again, have another chance, have another go with this come to the edge. Very similar energy to the Fool card in traditional tarot. So yeah, this person is waiting for like a green light, white light to begin again, to try again. Because they want victory, they want success of this connection. We've got this card victory. They feel like a lot can be done still. Things can be fixed if you love each other. And they have a lot of feelings for you, definitely. You are their biggest wish, biggest dream. Again, with this energy of manifestation I was feeling, we've got this card vision. It's like literal energy of manifestation, setting intentions. Yeah, and Nine of Cups. Very similar energy here with the swishing. They're dreaming about you for sure. The future with you and ending up with you and building a family with you. Let's get some messages from your person. Pile 3. What do they want you to know right now? What messages does your person have for you? We've got this card, I'm afraid to contact you. Yeah, after this conflict or difficult situation you were in, maybe anger, maybe like very heavy words that you shared with each other, like accusations or something like that, with this Five of Swords and despair. Maybe this person is still a little bit intimidated. They don't know what to say, how to be with you, how to behave, so you would, so the situation wouldn't repeat. Oh my gosh, then we've got this message. You were the best thing in my life. And I feel like you still are. They're still hoping that they can be with you. Oh, I wish I could take back my words. A lot of regret about what happened in the past. Let's get some more messages. What else does your person want you to know? Pile 3. Messages from your person. Yeah, that's what I was feeling all along throughout this whole reading. You are worth waiting for. And we've got, look at that. And then we've got this card waiting and Nine of Cups. Definitely waiting. Not going out and looking for like another partner, not getting into a new connection. Still waiting for you. Still wanting you. I have tried telling you the truth so many times, but I just cannot for some reason. Maybe that's why there is this confusion. Maybe that's why there are these conflicts. Because the truth is not out. Maybe you were not as honest with each other as you should have been. Especially this person. I cannot handle any more heartbreak. Yeah. I feel like you are in the same energy at the moment, Pile 3. What else? What else do they want you to know right now? Messages from your person, Pile 3. We've got this card, I'm in love with your body. So there is a lot of passion here. They like the way you look, your appearance. We also have this message, I have subconscious wounds that make me put on a facade. Yeah, hiding something, not being completely honest, not being authentic with their feelings and what they really want. They regret that. If you knew how I feel, I'm afraid you would find me obsessive. It could be that they're not letting on as much as the extent to how much you mean to them, how much they love you. Hiding things. And that is why this conflict and distrust growing between the two of you, in the past especially. So let's get a few more messages about how they feel. Pile 3, how does your person feel about you? Look at that, we've got this card, Unrequited Love. It says there is not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. I feel like that's how they feel about you, your side of things, that you don't love them enough, that you're not interested anymore, that you are done playing this game with them, arguing all the time, getting into this conflict, being in this confusing connection. Yeah, it's this worry. And at the bottom of the deck, we've got romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. But I feel like their feelings are very much strong for you, very strong, very powerful, with Nine of Cups and Ten of Cups. A lot of love here. Let's get a card from this deck as well. How does your person feel about you, pile three? We've got this card, new love. It says, embrace an opportunity for love in your work prospects or for spiritual growth. There is this feeling of a new beginning, a new chance for the two of you. Reconciliation, starting from a clean slate. We also had, what is it? We've got come to the edge. It's similar energy of the Fool in traditional tarot. Everything about a new beginning, a new chapter for the two of you. I feel like that's what they want. Because they know that with you they can get to this Ten of Cups, this ultimate happiness, happily ever after, this joy. Mm-hmm. So yeah, this is all I have for you, pile three. I hope this reading was helpful to you. I hope it gave you the answers you were looking for, has resonated with you. And I wish you lots of happiness and lots of love for yourself and for others. And I will see you in my next video. Bye-bye.